is proof that a monarch with a split proboscis can survive. They just have to immerse both halves in nitro solution. She's done. Her abdomen nice and plump. So you can see she's eating for real. Another way to make sure your monarch is getting food is put some dye in the food and then check their excretions on paper towel and make sure it's colored. I don't go through all that, so you could weigh them if you have a sensitive enough scale. I just think the best way is making sure they get nice and plump and fat, and you know they're drinking enough. Yeah, good girl. She's funny now when she's hungry, she comes over and starts working her little galley, I guess they're called, the two halves of a proboscis, its own joy. Just like all the monarchs, when they know you're coming to feed them, you see they start, oh, there's mom, I'll start looking for nectar. It's funny how they learn pretty fast, like, this is a 20% honey water solution. So no, you don't have to euthanize them, but yes, you do have to hand feed and make sure it's actually liquid nectar that they can really immerse, like the paper towel isn't really enough. They need to really be able to immerse both halves in there. And you can see her abdomen's getting nice and plump. Are you done, Mama? You can still eat more. Good girl. You are really fat though. You're really fat though, aren't you? Are you all done?